Welcome to this video. In this video, I will show you the tool that we're going to use. We'll be using a tool called Jupyter Notebook. In the past, we used Ripple.it, which was very nice, very good for the part we did, Turtle and basics programming in Python. But now we're moving into data analytics. Turtle can still be used to do the same thing. Ripplet can be used to do data analysis, but it has a weakness there. It's not the best tool for that purpose. So there's another tool which we'll look at it, which is called Jupyter Notebook. So how to get to Jupyter Notebook? If you go to your browser and write Azure Notebooks, this one from Azure is cloud computing, a platform from Microsoft. So you can program and create servers and computers and applications on the cloud, which nowadays is everywhere. So Microsoft is supporting Python, and this is strong evidence. Not only Microsoft, all big organizations are supporting Python because Python has widely spread and has so many libraries that simplify things. And you will see, we talk about Pandas. We will be using Pandas in the next video, and you will see how that can simplify the process of data analytics. Instead of spending hours and hours doing things, you do it just in a snapshot. So let's go to Microsoft Azure. When you get to this Azure, you need for sure to log in or register. Now we have two options when you click there. For me, I already logged in. I have account there, so I can log in. But for you, if it's first time, you click on use another account. So you go there and log in. You can use HCT. As a HCT student or staff member, you have access to Microsoft Azure, all the platforms. You have an agreement with Microsoft. But also, you can use your own account. This system, which Jupyter Notebook, is open to others. So Microsoft did not restrict it to only people who have agreement with Microsoft. But for me, I'm already there, so I will click and log in. Here is the page, will be presented with my name, and there's some data there. The one you need to look at is the libraries. Libraries is where you create your applications. It is like folder where you have your code, you have your data, and you have other information related to your project. So if you're working on a project related to anything, you create a library with the name of that project, and you upload all the files, and you create your program there. I'll show you an example. If I click there, you will see I have many files here. I will just create a new library now only. So we'll call it library one. Library practical one. So you can have anything in the name because that's the name. Here we'll say, call it practical one. Yeah, practical one L. Use meaningful name, but because I have so many libraries there, I didn't know which one I still did not use. So I'm just going for practical one L. So this name and this name can be different, but usually better to have them the same name. You also can use GitHub, and GitHub is a community of programmers network. Now we are there, so you can see we are in Udabi, libraries, and then practical L. So that's the full library I am in. You look here, the number of things. One, there is run. If you select any code you have here, you can run it. And if now we have no code, we have just this readme. Readme is just empty folder file that has nothing. This one is meant for adding some informations for later about the project. So you can write, say, this is what I did, this is the method I used, just like a report that you can use later for while you do the analysis, you document what you did that. Then there is share. If you want to share your code with someone else, you just click share and copy this URL and send it to him. So he will have access to it, okay? If someone shared anything with you, you will have access to read it, yeah? But you will not be able to run it or edit it unless you clone it. If you clone it, then clone it means you create a version for yourself. The version you create for yourself, you have full control. You can edit it, you can run it, you can do anything. So if someone shares something with you, you need to clone it to be able to edit it, okay? And this here will show you how many clones have been done with your document. If you share it with others, how many other people used your document and did clone it. That gives you an idea if there are more people using your document or not. Let's now create a Python code. So far, we're looking at the platform. We didn't create the code. So let us create one code and see how it works. Here is the plus. Click on plus. This one will allow us to create Python. So we call our practical one. Yeah, let's say practical one. That's not enough. Yeah, you need to decide. See, practical one is already there. Notebook file require language. Okay, sorry. So practical one is not there. But anyway, I need to select which version of Python I'm going to use. We will be using 3.6. The note we have for you, the tutorials we have, they are all written using the latest one, 3.6. There are other languages different from Python. You can see F-sharp, R project, and those. We're not going to talk about them now because they are not the subject of this course. But make sure you use Python 3.6, otherwise you will run into some issues. Okay, now you click, we did that one. You click new, and here is our file, practical one. And you see the extension, IPythonYNB, yeah? So that's it. You click on it now, it will now go to the Jupyter Notebook. So far, we haven't seen Jupyter Notebook. We just saw the platform where you create your files and the things. Now we're going to experience Jupyter Notebook for the first time. So it's loading on the screen and we'll see. Now, here it is. Let me just make it a little bigger for you. So if you can see it, if you are looking at it on a mobile phone or something. Good. See, the name is Jupyter, and here are the things. The first thing you will face is those cells. You can add new cells by just plus. You delete a cell by just delete cells. Okay? And you can copy and duplicate and things like that. Now, if we are in this cell, and let's do a basic example, something we did before. By the way, all the examples you did before, sorry, all the examples you did in Ripple, you can do here. So let's take an example, say x equal 10. Now each cell you notice has these brackets here. This will give you an idea. Did that cell run for once or twice or three times or did not run? Now this one did not run because there's no number here. If I want to run it, I have two options. One, I click run, or I do control enter. Control enter on keyboard like this. So you notice this became one. So now X is stored in the memory of my computer as 10. Okay? I can add a new cell. By the way, in one cell, you can add as much as you want lines. You're not limited to the number of lines. But dividing your code into cells will help you to run each cell on its own without the need to run the whole code from the beginning to the end. And this is one great advantage of Jupyter Notebook, which not in Ripple. Ripple, you want to run the code, you run everything. and assume you're reading a file that has a million or millions of records. It will take you time to just wait for it to read the file. But here you read it once in one cell, and then you keep referring to the data in the other cells without the need to read it again. And these are why those cells are there. So let's say here we will print the value of x. Okay? And hit, this time I'll hit this one. So you're getting 10. Of course, you can make this one looks better. X equal comma, like this, and run it. You will get maybe something a little bit nicer. So each cell can run on its own. Now, one thing important that I want you to know, because if you don't know this, you will make a mistake, you will spend time trying to fix it. Look at this. If I change this one to 20, and I didn't run the cell again, kept it as it is, I went to this one, and I run this one. What I'll get, well, I'll get 10. This one changed, but was not executed, did not run. Okay, so you run it first, and then you come and run this one, you will get the value 20. If you want to run all cells you have, you don't want to run one by one, you can go here, and this is usually you do when you open a code which already written. When you open the code, it's better to run all. You just go here, cell, run all, and then this will run all the code for you. Okay? Let me show you one more thing. If I come here and say x equal 40, okay, and run this cell, okay? Now, if I come back here, look at your code. I come here and run this cell again. What value of x I will get? Correct, I'll get 40 because for x change. I changed it here, I did run it. So if I run this one, I'll get 40, not 20. Although 20 before that, because 20, we didn't run it. The last thing we did run is 40. So the sequence is not of how the code appear on the screen. The sequence is on which cell we did run first, which cell we did run next, and next, and next. And that will change the value. So if I come here, for example, run this one, and come here, and run the second one, now back to 20. Because when I did run this one, x became 20. When I did run this one now, the value will come 20. So that's how those cells are created. Now, one more thing, if you want to add a cell between these two, you have two options. One is you go here and click plus. The other, if you are here, you go here and say insert, and you say above, insert cell above. Good. So if I come here and say x equal x plus 5 and run this one, now if I come here, what should I find? The value of x is becoming 25. Okay. Now, assume you have a file that contains the data that you want to analyze, spreadsheet and so many things. How you can upload it to your project? To do that, you go to data and you find upload. Yeah? Now you would say, oh, this is easy, I will do it. I know it's easy, you will do it. But there's one step I want you to know so you don't make that mistake. You click on upload. Then you go and find the file. I have a file here called grades. Yeah, let's open this file. This is fine. Now here is the one I want you to know. If you just click on start uploading, it will upload the file, but it will upload it to the main folder of your project, your account. So you will not find it in the same folder you want it to be. So you need to select from here, library, to have it in your folder. That's the step you need to remember. So you click and say start uploading. Now it's uploaded. How I know it is uploaded in the right place? go back here. These are the two files you have now. Let's just refresh. And you can see the file is there. So that basically what Jupyter Notebook. There are other things you see here. There are some, the kernel, for example. The kernel is the operating system. So if it crash or hang or doesn't respond back to you, you can do restart of it. But usually you don't need to do that for almost cases. So don't touch that one for some time. Other things you will get to know them as you go. So that's a quick introduction to Jupyter Notebook and how you can access it, and just a basic example of some calculation that we can do. In the next video, we'll talk about how we can read an Excel file and do some analysis on that file. Thank you.